good.
Hey.
What's up? Hello, people.
You missing
your buddy? Since he's married, you don't get to hang out with him as much? Huh? Y'all gonna steal room together on the road? Are y'all gonna steal room together on the road? We're just a question. It's not a statement, it's a question. Are you guys continuing to room on the road together?
TBD.
Okay.
All right, we will forego the opening statement and go right into questions for 10-year head coach Rick Barnes. If you have a question, just let me know, then we'll call around and pass out mics. Sorry, Ryan.
Where do you feel like you guys have grown the most as a team so far this preseason?
You know, I guess I would say versatility, maybe, that we know we got different ways we can play with different lineups, big, small, somewhere in between too, but still trying to figure out what is the best way to go for the most part, but just really waiting to get everybody on the court together at the same time. But overall, in fact, I think we've got really good, terrific camaraderie within our team, and we got a group of guys that that you can tell they continue to want to get better and everything that we're trying to do. And so the attitude's been good, but I do know they know after each scrimmage that we've gone out that we've got to continue to get better. And we have gotten better from scrimmage to scrimmage, but we still, like everybody, we have a way to go.
What was made last year about Chaz's efficiency numbers? What makes an efficient score?
Well, normally, when he's really playing his best basketball, he doesn't mess with the ball very much. You know, he gets to a shot, he gets where he needs to be, and it's been a really, I think he would tell you, a unique experience for him playing against a group of guys that bring the energy and effort that Jahmai and Zakai bring, and you know, Jordan Ganey's been with it too, and the standard that those guys play with every day has probably been as big an experience for him as anything that he's gone through, and he would tell you that. But we need him to, he's going to have to continue to do what he does, but do it at a much quicker pace.
Rick, Zakai's been a leader since he stepped foot on campus, but now with him kind of being the face of the team and the point guard, it being his team, just how have you seen his leadership even evolve going into his senior year?
Well, as you know, from day one, you know, it didn't take long before he established himself within our program, with our team, whether face the program or whatever that may be. I mean, it took him literally a week on campus 4 years ago to let everybody know that he was here to compete and play at the highest level. And what he does day in and day out is what makes him special. I mean, you all have watched him through the years, and the way he plays is the way he practices. He's extremely hard on himself, sometimes to a fault, but there's no one that wants to win, and no one is going to prepare any harder than Zakai. And he's wanting to have a great year, and not just individually, but he's, the one thing that defines him is he's wanting to win. And I think he's done a really good job again with Jahmai and Jordan trying to get the younger players and the new guys to understand we got some big holes to fill, and we need those guys to play at an extremely high level.
Go Reese, Rick, Mike, Roth.
Coach, where's JP at in his recovery, and how likely is he going to be ready for the season opener?
I don't, you know, he's doing a little bit more each day. I don't know where he is in terms of, you know, he's have a good day, then maybe he'll have a setback. You know, we need him, but Chad has done a great job, I think, of making sure that he'll be ready when time comes. But he's also a player that needs work and reps, and so they're working him back into where he is, you know, starting to get up and down the floor. But I don't know how to answer where he'll be or when he'll be. It just depends on how much he progresses over these next couple weeks.
I was going to ask a similar question on Zakai, but just on the court, off the court, you've known him for so long. Is there anything he does right now that surprises you or catches you off guard, just maybe not in his normal routine from the last couple of years?
No, I don't think anything he does. I mean, it's the expectation that he has for himself and that we have for him every day. I mean, when he's has a tough day, one, he's so brutally hard on himself that sometimes he makes it even tougher than it needs to be. But he's just so competitive within himself. And, you know, he wants to play the perfect game. I mean, he wants to do everything he can to get guys the ball where they need it. And I think when he gets himself in trouble is when he tries to take too much on it by himself. But he really understands. He's starting to more and more understand his teammates on this team. Like a year ago, he understood. I mean, quickly they figured out how they need our team last year needed to play. This team's not quite there yet. And I think the more Zakai gets there, the other guys will follow his lead.
With JP out, how have you seen Cade kind of rise into that? Is anyone else battling any injuries at this point?
No, again, you know, just Chaz and JP. And, you know, a week and a half ago, I think, was, you know, we had a little flu, ran through the team and all that. But other than that, these guys have been pretty resilient.
What's Chaz's?
He just had an inflamed something on his foot. But, he's been going in and out, bringing him back too slowly.
Coach, just how much different will you be in the post with swapping, bringing in Felix and Igor? Just, their style, their athleticism, their bodies.
We're different because now we've got Felix is a great rim protector, Cade, and I think that Cade has become one too, just because I don't know. We've talked about it many times how two guys have competed against each other every day for going on, it seems like forever. Felix and Cade go at each other in an extremely healthy way, and they both have made each other better. Both of them play above the rim. Both of them are real lob threats, but both of them are shot blockers. And then, you throw Igor. He's different than those two, but those two guys have so improved each other so much. And so we're different in the fact that we do have some legit lob threats. We have other guys that can do it, but to the extent of those two guys, not there. But other guys can do some things up on the front line in different ways. JP should be able to give us another guy that can do that once he gets back and can get his speed back and get where he can move at the pace that we're moving at right now as a team.
What does it mean to you to have your name on that Hall of Fame ballot?
Not much. I really haven't thought about it. Any good thing that has happened to me has been a true blessing from God and the players that he's blessed me with to be around. And I've always said the best part of this job is the daily interaction with players and watching them grow and be a part of it. And I've just been so blessed throughout my career with so many wonderful players and coaches that have been with me. But any individual award, really, when you're in a team sport, comes from the success of the team. But again, I'm just blessed to be here and so many blessings with so many wonderful people in my life.
What's it been like having two defensive-minded players like Felix and Jahmai kind of a part of the makeup of this team this season?
Well, there's really three. I mean, a list came out. Someone told me last week that they rated three of our guys as the top three defensive players in the country, and Jahmai and Z and Felix, and they definitely create some good situations for us on the other end. And the question will be, and we talk about as a team, who's going to keep coming to join that group, because we lost two really good defenders in Santi and Josiah, and we need some other guys to really step in there and fill that void along with really all the way down the line. Now, I do think that Jordan has gotten much better defensively, but we need Cade to continue to improve there, because what Josiah did defensively with his hands was something that we missed. I mean, he got his hands on so many balls and broke things away until we could get out and turn people over, and we need to get that from not just our frontline guys but our perimeter guys as well.
Rick, I was going to ask you about the defense as well. You obviously have several guys who are good individually playing defense, but with losing Santi and Josiah, where do you feel like the team is at defensively right now, especially with kind of the principles of your defense after losing veteran guys who knew where to be and what to do so often?
Not where we need to be. Not where we need to be. Getting closer, but not there yet. Guys understanding to do their work early can eliminate a lot of their problems. Too many guys still check out a little bit and are always playing catch up as opposed to doing the work early, knowing that something's going to happen. And within our principles, it's hard to get to sometimes with the way we run our offense, but it can be done. But it's got to be tough mentally. You got to have some real cardio toughness, and you've got to stay alert. And right now, we've got too many guys away from the ball, not staying in tune with the ball. Player watching probably more than anything, and not reacting to the basketball.
What gives you confidence that you guys won't take a step back offensively compared to where y'all were last season?
Well, I do think the versatility and you know, we worked hard in a lot of different areas. You know, we're really happy with where we're moving with our inside game and guys that we feel we can throw it to, and people want to play. You know, in the past, people have pretty much said, we're going to let you play 2-on-2 with those, you know, with Zakai and a post guy. And I think we've made really good strides there because of how hard our post guys, and we know what Zakai is going to do. And Jordan, another guy that, you know, that has really, in the last 2 weeks, he got off to a great start this summer. You know, Bishop really was playing well. Then Zakai came back, and that's a whole new experience for him, having to deal with Zakai every single day. But the last 2 weeks, he's made as much strides defensively as anybody on our team, and he's highly competitive. He wants to win. He's still trying to figure out what we're doing from an offensive situation, but defensively, his effort, his rebounding has been really impressive the last 2 weeks.
Coach in the back here, Jahmai Mashack worked really hard on his jump shot in the offseason. How have you seen it evolve and improve?
Well, he has. I mean, he's worked on it really for 4 years, and you know, he's a guy now that when he takes the shots that we know that he practices and gets set, you know, we're really surprised if he misses them, as long as he does what he practices, and he's worked hard at it, and we need him to do that. And if he's open, he's worked hard enough to be a guy that we expect to shoot open shots when he gets them, and he's done a good job. He really has. I think probably pretty much through the preseason, he's probably been our best consistent 3-point shooter overall.
Coach, back here, what's your approach to getting transfers acclimated, especially when those transfers are only going to be here for a year?
Get who acclimated to transfers?
Transfers, yeah.
Well, I think you got to coach everybody the same way, but it's obviously you're hoping with them being older that they can pick up things quicker. You hope that they've seen a lot of different things in their time in college basketball, and we don't slow down. We're not going to wait really for anybody, and we expect them to figure it out pretty quickly. We're going to do what we need to do from our end, but we also expect them to do what they need to do from their film study, their individual film study, and different things. So they know what they know coming in, what the expectations are, and what we expect from them. And we always talk about versatility and being able to. The more positions you can play allows you to probably be able to get more minutes. But we don't lower the expectation for them. We've got probably a higher bar than they've ever had, and we really expect them to live up to it.
Questions? All right, last two here, Ryan and Rob.
Where's Cam at right now, and what do you want to see from him to keep improving?
You know, Pro Day the other day, shot the ball well. He's still some of the fundamental things he's got to continue to work with, but, you know, a guy that what we, you know, and we look at his ability, we've got extremely high standards for him. He's a guy that we feel should be an outstanding defensive player. Still got to take care of the ball better than he does, but he's improved. I think Cam over the last 2.5 weeks have made strides too, and really trying to simplify things, making it easier on himself by not trying to overdo things. And we know that again, he's one of those guys when he gets his feet set and not rushed. You know, he'll shoot the ball at a high percentage, but he's no different than anybody else on our team right now. We talk about taking care of the ball and being able to finish the possession defensively and offensively the way we want to. And he is getting better. He isn't. But we need him to get there quicker. And so we're going to push him to get there.
Last one from Rob.
Coach, where, if anywhere, have you changed in the last 4 or 5 years as far as points of emphasis offensively with the advent of all the analytics? Is there anything that you pay more attention to or emphasize more now than you did, say, 5 years ago?
Well, like some of you guys, better not used to. Yeah. That answer your question? No, I don't know about if we've changed. We always adjust. I will say that. We're constantly adjusting. I mean, even a year ago, you know, this time a year ago, we had no idea Dalton would do what he did. I mean, we knew that he had the ability offensively to do some things that we hadn't had, but where he was defensively, I'm telling you, I'd tell him, say, hey, I don't care how many times you score the ball. If you're going to give up that many points, what are we doing here? We're just trading your baskets for their baskets. But you know what we didn't know was how hard he was willing to work. Players will make coaches adjust. Good players make coaches adjust. They will. And it could happen this year. We at the end of the year, we ended up doing things that we hadn't even thought about doing this time of year. But from the way the season settled in, the way we started growing as a team and where we started doing things, we added stuff to try to take advantage of different guys. And I would imagine that's going to happen with this team. I'm not sure exactly who with yet. But I know it needs to happen with this team. So we need some guys to show us consistently what we can count on every time they go out there. And as a coaching staff, we'll make the necessary adjustments to take advantage of it.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you, guys.